Get ready to match the stars from Love Boat, Fred Grandy, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Bonnie Stevens, Bill Cullen, and Marcia Wallace as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 79. And now, here's the star of Match Game 79, Gene Rayburn.
Thanks for joining us.
Hi, Connie. Good.
Well, my old friend Bill Cullen. I'm going to muss up your hair.
Well, I've already mussed up yours.
Very amusing. Humor at my expense already, eh, Gene?
No, I just want to give you a little kiss.
What, am I a dog?
No, I just...
Don't you dare.
No.
Okay.
All right. Okay. Just simple little kiss. Oh, sweet Marcia Wallace. Love that lady.
So you're Fred Grandy, huh?
Yeah, that's what I'm told.
Yeah.
Well, are you looking to start something?
We've got a little tradition here.
Yes, sir.
You're the new kid on the block.
Right.
And we want to give you a proper welcome.
Ah!
Be still, my heart.
No, I just do that with the ladies. I was just funning you. I wouldn't kiss you.
Too.
Yes.
Over here we have Ambie Charles and Larry Carter Jr. Applause. Ambie is the current champ with $9,050.
Great.
How do you feel about that, Ambie?
Very, very happy.
Good. Yes. What are you going to do with it?
Put an addition onto my room for my baby. He sleeps in the dining room now.
You know, for $9,000, you know what you can build today? A little box like this, and that's what your kid is going to sleep in. Now, Larry, how are you doing? You're in the middle. We're in the middle of round two here.
Right.
Well, you've matched everybody, haven't
right,
you?
So far.
So she's got one shot at it, and let's give it to her right now. You want A or B?
B.
Okay.
Doesn't say don't write, Fred.
Oh, I see.
I have to
in
explain
the previous
certain
time,
stuff
right,
to him.
Brett and Charles lay out. The rest of you, please respond to this. Okay. Fat Fred is really fat. Hey, John. Did you rehearse him? Holy mackerel, that's good. Fat Fred is really fat. He went swimming off the coast of Florida. From the air, he looked like blank.
Get ready for another week of the older woman helping the young handsome boy. Another whole week of this.
Just remember, he kissed me.
They should you do. Kissed me, Jim.
Oh, I beg your pardon, yes. Okay.
He'll only hurt you, Fred.
Only moderately. Ambie, Fat Fred is really fat. He went swimming off the coast of Florida. From the air, he looked like...
A whale.
A whale. He said a whale. It's going to be very interesting now. Ambie, you must match all four stars whom you've not matched previously. Fred, you're up first.
Well, I'm still getting over the kiss, so... I said whale.
Whale! Very good. Okay. There's one whale, Ambie. Okay, Connie Stevens, baby.
I thought it was a geography lesson. I said Cuba.
Cuba! That means Larry Carter wins the game. What'd you have, Bill? Nassau. We're saying goodbye to Ambie Charles, who is leaving here not unhappy because she has $9,050. Congratulations, Ambie. Bye. And we'll spin her off and spin a message for America. Here it is. Okay, Larry, is your first time up here. Here's the way it goes. We've got this big super match for you here. We polled a studio audience not too long ago. Very smart bunch like these. And we said, write down your best answer to this. Blank of youth.
Oh, boy.
Now, the answer they gave most often will get you $500 if you match it. If you match their second most popular answer, you get $250. If you team up with the third, you get $100. Three of our six stars are permitted to offer some assistance.
Bill, I would say, ready for mine?
Yes,
ready for yours. Something that I have visited many times.
Yes.
Was never open when I was there. Fountain.
Fountain of Youth.
Tiny.
Tiny, have you got one?
That's what I was going to say.
You were going to say Fountain of Youth? Well, he said that.
Bottle of Youth. I don't know.
Now, wait a minute.
Time of Youth.
Time of Youth. Okay, that's hers.
That Charles.
Charles?
There what, isn't a third
yeah.
one.
What I'm going through now, the pains of youth. No.
The pains of youth.
It's good.
The pains of youth and the fountain of youth and the time of youth are the three they have given you. Now, at this point, you have the option. Choose one of those or give us one of your own.
I think fountain of youth is good.
I think so, too. I think you've made a wise decision. I hope it's up there. Let's begin down at the bottom and look at the $100 number. Sweet bird of youth. Now, how come none of you thought of that?
I myself did.
You thought of it.
Okay. All right. Let's look at the $250 number. Spirit of youth is another good one. Yes. Very good.
That's what you've got, baby. You've got the spirit, but nothing else.
In an old body, I have the spirit of youth. Thank you. You're not getting any tonight. Okay. Let's go to the top and look at the $500 number. Fountain of Youth. And a boy, Larry Carter. Okay. Now, you won $500 means at least you'll play for us 10 times that amount or $5,000. But if you get a lucky spin of the star wheel, you can double your money and play for $10,000. Have a go at it. Good luck. We'll all root for a double, right? Here we go. Any of the gold star area, Larry, and you're in. From $5,000 to $10,000. Fred, aren't you lucky?
What does this mean?
This means it's your first time on the show. You don't know how to play the game, and he got you.
Yeah.
Stand on the blue dot and face me, if you would, please, this way.
Okay, my answer is popsicle.
No, wait a minute. I have to ask a question.
Oh, right. First time, you know.
That's your first time. Now, audience, please don't say out an answer. We don't want to dampen your enthusiasm, but if you give him a rotten answer and then he blows it, the $5,000, you have to pay him there. No. Okay. He will give a verbal response and you will write yours. Blank awards. Blank awards. Okay. Now, Fred made up his mind very quickly. If you give us the answer that he's written on the card, we give you $5,000. What do you say?
Oscar awards.
Oscar awards. Well, the rule I point out before we get Fred's answer, and this part of the show, it has to be an exact match. So let's turn around and find out what Fred has on the card. You have to show us a card now, Fred.
Well, we thought along the same lines, but I said Academy.
Academy.
Sorry,
gee, that is right. Too bad. That's the rule here.
Well, when you give get him to half. The
give him half.
That's
no,
a good idea.
When you get to the real big money part, it has to be an exact match exactly. There. That's the way it goes. Well, listen, you got a total of $600, and you're going to have another go here in another game with Carolyn Reifner. We welcome you and like to get acquainted with you before we start the competition. May we find out where you're from? Tell us anything you want about your life. I see you're wearing a ring. You're wearing two rings. Three rings.
She has three husbands.
Well.
I'm originally from Evanston, Illinois.
Yep. A wonderful little town.
Yes, and I live in Redlands, California, and I'm a secretary for the Valley Water District in San Bernardino.
You are.
She likes your boss.
You like your work.
I sure do. And I'm married to a wild and crazy guy.
No kidding. Is he here?
No, he's too crazy.
Oh.
He's locked
I keep
up.
Him at home.
I see. Well, I hope he's not being wild and crazy while you're gone, honey. We'll start this game in a moment or so, Carolyn, right after we do a little business with America. Okay? Okay, here we go. All right, Carolyn, you have a choice here of A or a B.
B, please.
B it is. Everybody plays. Harvey said, I just took a no-frills flight on El Cheapo Airline, and it was terrible. They don't have seat belts. Instead, the stewardess blanks you to the seat. Okay. All right, Carolyn, here we go. Harvey said, I just took a no-frills flight on El Cheapo Airline, and it was terrible. They don't have seat belts. Instead, the stewardess blanks you to the seat.
Hog ties you.
Hog ties you. I didn't think girls from Evanston said hog tie. I thought only people from Oklahoma and Texas said hog tie. What do you say, Fred?
Well, I said scotch tapes, but of course I was traveling first class.
Oh, naturally. He's crazy, isn't he?
Yeah, cute's a button.
Yeah, okay.
He's thin, too. I like thin people.
Leave him alone. Don't touch any part of his body.
Yeah, I'm jeans.
You want me to move over?
They're going to do tea and sympathy later this summer.
Wait a minute, that's not the punch. What part am I playing? The lady?
No, the puck.
I just do it, you know, why not?
Right.
Clues.
Glues you to the seat. Okay. Little lady over there says hog tie.
Two glues there.
All right. No frills, El Cheapo Airline, terrible. They don't have seat belts. Instead, the stewardess hog ties you to the seat. What'd you say?
Well, three glues.
Three glues there. Listen, I don't want to get too personal, but what the hell happened to your hair? I mean, you know, I don't read Vogue or any of that.
This is what I look like when I get out of the shower. I am really Italian, you see?
Oh, I see.
This is without 3 hours of blow drying.
I see. This is the latest
don't
thing.
Don't be fresh. It's supposed to be.
It's the latest thing.
She whips it with an egg beater.
Well, all right. Okay. And you, Bill?
I'm wearing her old hair. And I didn't go glues. I'm old-fashioned. I went nails.
Nails it. Stewardess nails you to the seat. What do you say there, Marsh, honey?
I say, how you doing?
Okay.
Well, I'm not quite as rude as Bill, but Staples.
Yeah! Staples. Well, we didn't get one tie there, Carolyn, and I thought that was a rather nifty answer. Okay, Larry, here's your first rounder. It says, Frank said, when I was born, instead of a crib, my parents kept me in a closet. For years, I thought I was a blank. Larry is thinking about it. We're ready? Here we go. Frank said, when I was born, instead of a crib, my parents kept me in a closet. For years, I thought I was a blank.
Coat hanger.
Coat hanger. Okay. He gave a very conventional answer.
Yeah.
He said coat hanger.
I went with scotch tape again.
You did.
No. Coat hanger.
Oh, you said coat hanger. Very good, Fred. Good game player, too.
Sure.
In addition to being a good kisser.
You. Is he a good kisser?
Yes.
We'll check that out, honey, at the dinner hour. I said a double-breasted suit with two pairs of pants.
Uh-huh. Very good. Anything that's in a closet would be acceptable, Charles.
Stop dreaming.
Hanger! Hanger! Oh, that's another one. That upper tier is a caution, I tell you that.
What a bunch of cut-ups.
Yes. For years, they kept me in a closet. For years, I thought I was a...
Gonna win a lot of money today, Larry.
Coat hanger. Three for Larry. Yes.
There are closets and there are closets, Gene.
Right, you have a look of consternation on your face.
I do.
Why is that, Bill?
Because I was thinking of the closet right off the kitchen. Broom.
Oh, you were thinking of the broom closet.
Yes. Wrong.
Right. Well. Okay.
Easy go.
Nice try, though.
Yes. I'd have a look of consternation, too, but I don't know what that is. So I'll just say broom.
Broom.
Oh, you're another guest.
Good.
Yeah. Okay, you must come out of your broom closet there. So now we go to round two here. It's 3-0. Favor the champ. Carolyn, again, you have a choice of A or B.
I'll take B again, please.
B again. All right. Here we go. Humpty Dumpty said, I'll never get into a fight with my wife again. It was terrible. She ran after me with a blank.
Wait a minute. I was looking at you, and I was so overwhelmed, I didn't listen to
Humpty Dumpty said.
Yeah. Humpty Dumpty.
Humpty Dumpty.
Yeah.
Humpty. I'll never get into a fight with my wife again. It was terrible. She ran after me with a blank.
watch this answer. That'll be the same as everyone else on this row, because she only looks over here when she gets tired of looking at the young boy for the answer. She'll look over here at the old guy. Now watch carefully. Get your camera. Get your
camera. How do you know he's a young boy? He could be dyeing his hair. He could be as old as I am.
How come he went in and out of makeup faster than any of us?
Oh, that's the clue, yeah. How come, Fred?
I know them.
Okay, here we go, Carol. Humpty Dumpty said, "I'll never get into a fight with my wife again. It was terrible. She ran after me with a...
egg beater."
Very good answer. All right.
What else?
Well, if you were Julia Child, you might say whisk.
Or Cuisinart. Oh,
yeah. Yes. Yeah. Mm-hmm. What do you say?
Or if you were Brett Somers, you might say hammer. He was hard-boiled, Humpty Dumpty. So you would have...
at Charles and not me.
Humpty Dumpty was hard-boiled. Egg beater,
yeah. Okay, Carol. We got two now.
All right.
Okay, Connie Stevens.
I think you terrible. Almost had six before Brett put her 2 cents in.
She ran after me with an egg beater. You got a little egg beater there? There's a four for Carolyn. What?
I so rarely matched, I just got so excited. Egg beater.
Oh, good. I thought it was me. So, Carolyn, you're up to 5. He has 3. You got one more shot at it right after this word for you. Larry, here's what you have to do. 2 to tie, 3 to win. Ready? Here we go. In Washington, D.C., Al said, "Last Thanksgiving, we really had a turkey for dinner. My wife invited blank." You don't play?
Wait, just a minute, sweetheart. Now, this is important. In Washington, D.C., Al said, "Last Thanksgiving, we really had a turkey for dinner. My wife invited..."
Washington, D.C.?
You don't play.
Washington, D.C. is the operative phrase.
Leave him alone. He don't play.
I love you.
There's a whole list.
All right. Larry, in Washington, D.C., Al said, "Last Thanksgiving, we really had a turkey for dinner. My wife invited blank."
Billy Carter.
Billy Carter. Billy Carter. Yeah. Now, he said, "Billy Carter." What do you say?
I said Billy Carter, too. Mr. Carter.
Mr.
Fight with that.
That's a hard
one. Gotcha. Got
I mean, you really are a mean broad.
You know that. I'm on your side, Larry.
I mean, you put Ira in a terrible position because, you know, when you refer to Mr. Carter in Washington, D.C.
No, President D.C. Carter.
No, President. I say
see,
President.
We got another
Who
point
Billy
on
Carter
our side.
Mr. in yeah. the right mind.
Yes. Well, anyway, you made it tough for him, but he did the only thing he could do and gave you a match. All right, what have you got there? It's time for you to show and tell.
I got Billy Carter.
Billy Carter. In the hospital, he smokes 5.5 packs of cigarettes a day. They said, "Stop that." But he's going to be okay. What have you got there?
The thing I like about the sixth seat, there's never any pressure.
Well, now, wait a minute. It's a tie score here, you see. Mm-hmm. So you can't be a villain in any case, because it'll either end in a tie or a win for him.
Okay.
She's not going to be too thrilled with you if you come up with Billy Carter, but you can't win them all.
Thanks. Billy Carter.
Billy Carter. Gifts will be coming your way from Match Game 79. Thank you for being with us. Carolyn Raisner, ladies and gentlemen. We're going to spin a message just for America. How do you feel? Yeah. stars. Just a second or two to take here to say that what's his name up here over my left shoulder is directing a Broadway show by Ira Levin. Going to open at the Palace Theater sometime.
In a few days.
In a few days.
The end
and
of
it's, Julie Harris is in
and
it.
Jack Weston.
And Jack Weston.
And a wonderful actor. It takes you 3 weeks to learn his name.
Who's that?
Rene Aubergenois.
Rene Aubergenois.
Yeah, but that's a hard name. What's the matter
he
with Ray Smith?
He went to Carnegie Mellon with my daughter Lynn.
Yes?
Yes.
Lynn Aubergenois?
No. Lynn Rayburn. He's a marvelous actor.
It's a very funny play. At the Palace.
At the Palace Theater. Okay. All right. Don't forget to watch Fred Grandy on The Love Boat. A nifty show. Gene Rayburn here. Join us next time for Match Game 79.